To ask you about your solo album, because now I know the story as to why you and your son wound up discussing that you guys needed to do the solo album, but I was wondering if you could share that with the rest of the Notebook Years, because I love that story.
Well, we were in Arkansas. He lives in L.A., and he's like very, you know, just works a lot as his band, the Breakastra, and everything, and they're a very funk band. So we were sitting around the river in Arkansas, the Kings River, and he said, you know, like, you played on all these people's records, and so your guitar playing's all over the place, and you play with Little Feet, and it's Little Feet's thing. He says, but, you know, people don't really know what it is, the kind of music that I've grown up hearing you play just by yourself in the house and the kind of stuff when you write your songs. And he says, on top of that, he says, like, my grandkids, if I ever have any kids. Miles, if you ever have any kids.
Or is that a chop chop?
Yeah, I don't know. But, you know, he's going, you know, we ought to have a, because we were looking at scrapbooks with my grandma, with my mom, his grandmother. And he was going, you know, we ought to have a oral scrapbook, an audio scrapbook of, like, the way you play and stuff. Just your thing that, like, I can play for my kids and their kids, and they'll know what their granddad sounded like. They won't just listen to a Glenn Campbell record and go, he's playing guitar on that.
Can you hear him? Can you hear him?
Yeah. So that's how, you know, that kind of gave us the idea, because it was his idea, and it made it so that he would do it, because I didn't think I'd ever be able to talk him into, you know, sitting down and working with me. But it was really a nice project. We did it, you know, as he's a real analog freak, so we did it all, like, to tape, and then we went down to digital at the very last moment, you know. And so it's got a real big bass sound, and it was a real labor of love for him, you know, working with his dad, and it was great. You know, I just loved it. We're going to do it again.
Sounds terrific.
Thank you.
Love that album.
Thank you.
Now, you have shared the stage with many tremendous musicians over the years, and I just was wondering, if someone gave you the opportunity and said you can go back and relive one moment from your career, do you have any idea? Gosh. I mean, a moment that just took your breath away, do you have any idea what that moment was?
Yeah, there's several moments. One moment, particular moment that took my breath away was I worked for Bob Dylan for approximately 3 years, and the first part of the time I worked with him was he was doing his Religions. He did the album Saved and Shot of Love, and he had just done Slow Train Coming. So he was doing nothing but gospel music, which was a real trip, because he had this great band. He had Jim Keltner on drums and Spooner Oldham playing piano, who played on all the Muscle Shoals, Aretha Franklin, I Never Loved a Man the Way I Love, you know, all those great, soulful things. Spooner played piano on them, you know, and had this gospel piano player, and I think about six gospel singers, and Tim Drummond playing bass, myself playing guitar. And it was like, I mean, just the ultimate in gospel music. I mean, if you like gospel music, it was like this stuff. I mean, these girls were the best, you know. They would come out and do an hour of just, you know, tambourine, you know, down, hardcore gospel stuff. It was just as soulful as you can imagine. And then Bob was, you know, he was sincere about what he was doing, and it was like the music was really good. And it was a great experience, because there was controversy. People hated it some places, and it was just like, you know, real fun. But one time, we'd go to rehearsal, and he started, without saying anything, he just started playing, you know, his old songs again. You know? We started rehearsing Girl from the North Country, and we started playing like a Rolling Stones. And so he did this thing all the time I was working with him. Once a year, we'd go to the Warfield Theater in San Francisco, play for 3 weeks, I think. It was either 2 or 3 weeks, a long time. And we went up there, and that was the first place that he started playing his old songs again. Because it was the greatest. The last time we were there, somebody had a big sign that said, "Jesus loves your old songs." Which I thought was perfect.
That's terrific.
I thought it was perfect. But anyway, the first time we started playing Like a Rolling Stone, and there was that millisecond when the first song, and the crowd realized, I think we did a few songs from Slow Train Coming and all that, and it was like, yeah, okay, here we are, we're doing the same thing. And then all of a sudden he started going, you know, da 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 da, and it was like, oh man, the place just went nuts. And I'm just even thinking about it right now, I just got chill went up my spine, man. I was like, You know, it's unbelievable. He's going, you know, once upon a time. And I'm like, oh, my God. I'm standing here, Bob Dylan, singing. The whole place is going, how does it feel? And it was like, feels great, man. It was great. It was a great moment. So that would be one that I would like to hear. I'd like to do it again.
Anybody would like to live that
it was
moment.
Cool, man. It was cool.
The energy of that whole show had just had to be
yeah,
amazing.
It just jumped up about five notches when everybody realized they were going to start hearing some old tunes, you know.
Good stuff.
Yeah, it was good. His gospel songs that he wrote were excellent. I mean, they were great. He still says it's some of the best music he made was that period.
Yeah.
And it was, because everybody was like real focused, and he was real straight, man, and he was on it, man. He was just on it.
Yeah.
You know, he sang great, you know, and he was just on this thing, you know.
Yeah.
So that was cool. Always like passion. That's what it was, a lot of passion. He wasn't going through the motion. He was on, you know, he was on a mission from God. So it was good.
Well, and that's what's kept him going.
Yeah, man.
You too. Passion.
Yeah, passion. That's what it's all about.
Absolutely.
You're right.
Well, listen, I am hoping that I can talk you into playing something off of your solo album while you're here today.
Well, I'll run downstairs and see if I can find an acoustic guitar, and if I can borrow one from Paul or something, see if we can get something together.
That would be great. Well, listen, thank you so much for spending some time with me today.
You betcha.
And this is Cindy with MoBoogie.net at the Oriental Theater in Denver, and Fred Tackett. Thank you so much for hanging with us, and we'll see you next time. MoBoogie.net, that's what you get. MoBoogie.net. Oh, boogie! Hey! Dot net. That's what you get. Hey, hey, hey. We got Chris. Ha. We got Rocky.